is incredible how we can get the apricot. It's now in aromas here. And then we get all these dark fruits as well, the blackberries, black cherries, and they're quite nice and smooth tannins, yeah? So
I can taste a little bit of apricot.
Yeah. And I would like to ask you, Alex, how did you make this wine?
I am Priscilla.
I'm Renata.
I'm Paula. We've come all the way from Brazil
to unravel the mysteries of the Australian wines.
Let us take you on a tour and discover who was behind these famous labels. Come on!
Greenock Creek Wines was founded in 1984, located in Barossa Valley, and known for its big, bold flavoured, old school style wines. Today, we're talking to marketing manager Kieran Lomax.
The property was bought in 1975, the original property, which backs onto Seppeltsfield. From 1994, this property was bought. The Rowanfield Road vineyards that we were standing in before produced some wines in the early 90s that received 100 points from Robert Parker, Wine Advocate, and that's the reputation really pushed the brand on.
Enter the winemaker, Alex Peel, to find out the secrets that make their wines so unique and so successful.
Traditionally, all hand-picked, hand-pumped over, hand-dug out into traditional basket presses, and that's all about trying to retain that. The power, but also the delicate fruit flavours we have. We don't want any bitter, harsh tannins, because while we have very powerful, rich wines, they're not tannic.
So join us and our Chinese guest, Ziki, as we discover what's behind the Greenock Creek Wines label.
Cheers!
Hi guys, we're here with the apricot block Shiraz. Can you tell us a little bit about the label, about the name?
Out of everything that we produce, it's probably a lot of people's favourite. They're really affectionate about this particular wine. So the label itself, Greenock Creek, as a label, it's always been this style. So for two vintages, the first two vintages produced were one strange old pink and green label, and then a label that was written directly onto the bottle. And then from 1986, this particular style here.
You were telling that we have like a lot of handmade things in here. So we have like the label that reminds something very old school, but with like all the handwriting here. So something that reminds the family, the beginning.
The founder of the business was a stonemason.
Okay.
So he was a stone worker, he was a bricklayer, and this particular shape here with the arch has that stone arch sort of style to it, and then the framework that you see on older buildings. So whether or not that's where it came from, that's what I like to think.
Okay. Yeah.
So the Grenache that we have up here is called the Cornerstone Grenache. We'll taste that in a minute, but again, that's another stonemason.
Yes, Greenock Creek is one of the first wineries in the Barossa Valley to become single site, and we've stayed that way through the whole history. So unlike a lot of other vineyards that might choose different regions to blend to a style, we're very much, this site makes a wine, no blends, no changes. And we're very lucky, as you can see, we've got some very old Cabernet and Shiraz vines on the property. They're somewhere between 120 to 130 years old, which make a very special wine and very intense. It's a very rich soil.
We can actually see, see like a very clay, right?
Yeah, very clay with a bit of sand and loam through there. Really rich soil and very deep root structure. So we don't actually need to water these vineyards much at all. And in some years, potentially like this year, none at all.
So they're very low yielding, right?
Very low yielding. As you can see, you do unfortunately lose some of the canes that over time die back. But this for me is a very special vineyard.
And the apricot ones, what you're going to try today, comes from the hills?
Yep, the apricot's up on the hillside there, so it doesn't look like much elevation, but we go from some of the same sort of loamy soil up to real gravel and shale on the top of the hill. And it's called apricot block because it was an old apricot orchard. That was the original planting there.
There you go,
that's good. When Michael and Annabelle bought this property, they took out the apricot trees, planted a vineyard. Strangely enough, that flavour of apricots is still in the wine. So there is a real stone fruit element in the wine. And again, that's a great example of a unique terroir, as the French like to call it.
The hills give you different aspects as well for the wine. So the shallow soil, as you say, is one aspect.
Yep.
And then the way you're planting as well, like more concentration grapes.
Yeah, so the vines up on top of the hill really struggle. They get really intense flavours. And we often pick that in two picks. So we might pick the hill section even a week to even week and a half before we pick the bottom, to get the same concentration. And we as you'll taste later, it's a very intense wine, and that's what Greenock Creek's about.
We have a Sommie Grenache as well here in the property.
Yeah, so not quite as old as Roperoi Cabernet, but the little bush vines on top of the hill there, up on the contour.
Yep.
They're somewhere between 80 and 90 years old.
Yep.
Again, very low yielding. We're lucky in Australia having a lot of old vine Grenaches, because that was the history of the history of Australia making fortified wines.
Yeah.
And they've survived, and they make beautiful dry red table
wines. And the Grenache love a Mediterranean climate. Yeah, so that's probably one of the, we actually grow here so well.
Yeah,
you know? The Grenache is beautiful.
They're so suited to the environment where all these other vineyards will lose their leaves. You still look up and you have a nice tinge of yellow or orange on the Grenache. It's a beautiful sight. They always hang their leaves on before they go dormant for a lot longer than any other variety.
So guys, we're going to taste the Apricot 2018, and I would like to ask you, Alex, how did you make this wine?
All our wines go into barrels. Now, we don't like using a lot of newer barrels, only a very small percentage.
Yep.
It's more about seasoned barrels and retaining the fruit essence. This wine goes in particularly predominantly American oak.
Yes.
Other grapes go into French oak, American oak. For certain times, there's no rules.
Yes.
We just make the best wines we can. When we think they're ready to come out of barrel, we bottle them. So I don't like to stick by a rule book. That's partly why we're paid to make wine.
That's good. And the American oak could give like a little bit more the coconut flavours. It's a little bit different.
Yeah, a bit of coconut, a bit of sweetness to the wine. So a block like the apricot, which has got a natural sweetness, I think that really gets enhanced by the American oak, where if you try one of our other wines called the Alice Shiraz, that's more savoury, more coffee bean, and I think that lends itself more to French oak, which is more spice and toasty.
So yeah, great. So and actually we can smell that, guys. It's incredible how we can get the apricot smell and aromas here. And then we get all these dark fruits as well, the blackberries, black cherries, and they're quite nice and smooth tannins, yeah. So
I can taste a little bit of apricot.
Yeah. Well, have some fat in the
it's a very full bodied but very rich one at the same time.
Yeah.
As good as the drinking is now, it will last and last and last. And Greenock Creek's known historically for wines that last 15, 20 years in the cellar.
You can tell because the long finish as well, because after you finish, you're still tasting the wine. So it's quite a fine wine. It's bring down everywhere. And
Yeah. That's very powerful.
Thanks for coming, everyone.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you. Cheers.
We're going to taste the Grenache 2017.
Traditionally, all hand-picked, hand-crushed into open fermenters, which are hand-pumped over, hand-dug out into traditional basket presses. And that's all about trying to retain that, the power, but also the delicate fruit flavours we have.
And it's very gentle when you use basket presses.
Very gentle, yes. It's essentially just a big ram that pushes down, and we have a lot of control over the extraction rates.
Yes.
We don't want any bitter, harsh tannins, because while we have very powerful, rich wines, they're not tannic. They're just very subtle, rounded, rich and voluptuous.
So you end up in doing like a less quantity and more quality, yeah?
With exactly right, yes. Yeah. The whole mandate of making the wines is to make the best quality we can.
Yeah.
If that means sacrificing a little bit of yield, that's completely fine. It's just, yeah, the best we can do.
Yeah, that's great. This comes from the 19 years old vineyards.
Yes, so yeah, that's the vineyard we saw before up on the side of the hill. Grenache is always the last variety we pick. Just hangs in there, very slow ripening. But produces a very floral, pretty wine. So I see a lot of strawberry fields in there, some rhubarb.
Yeah.
But being 2017 was a very cool year in the Barossa, so I see a bit of spice and almost a bit of white pepper there in the finish as well.
Yeah. I get some earthy, some spices on the nose, and the palate, you get
I quite like this one, so I feel like very elegant, easy drink. And have you tried Grenache with Chinese food? It's very fruity and the finish a little bit sweet. Very good with the steamed dumplings together. Try that.
Oh,
it's very yummy, trust me.
Maybe it's a good idea for my dinner.
It's such a versatile variety. It's glad to see it's becoming popular and very fashionable again, because it's making great red wines, fortifieds, rosés. It's such a versatile variety.
Yeah, very popular here in the Barossa. Cheers to the Grenache, guys.
Cheers. Cheers.